to my channel, where today, we learn a little bit of science. Well, for a long time, I haven't posted on Acillus Grip, so today, we're going to do it. Now, we're going to talk about the inner planets in Acillus. But guys, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell. Also, hit the like button if you don't want to miss newly awesome and posted videos. So let's get started! First, we are going to introduce it. The planets are divided into inner planets and outer planets, depending on their distances from the sun. So, they're divided like this. The first one is close to the sun. The four planets that's close to the sun is called inner planets. And the last one is called outer planets because it's far away from the sun. But mostly, we're going to stick on the inner planets. Okay? So, let's go. So the inner planets, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. So, the inner planets are all rocky planets. They are all made out of rock. First one is Mercury. Well, Mercury is the closest planet to the sun. And it's very hot and dry also, because it's really close. Well, Mercury is the smallest planet and it's less than a half of the size of the Earth. So it's really, really small. It's smaller than Venus, it's smaller than Earth, and smaller than Mars. And also, Mercury has no atmosphere. So the sky is pitch black. Although you can see the really bright sun, but the sky is pitch black, so you cannot see anything. It has many craters on its surface, like the moon. So the craters are like the little holes, but not like its little gaps or dents. It's not deep down, it's just a dent. It's just half like this. Not deep down. So, Mercury has no moons. Yeah. Mercury takes 59 Earth days to rotate once, and it takes 88 Earth days to rotate around the sun. So it's close to the sun and it's also smallest and the fastest also. Next is Venus. So, you know, you say, oh, Mars is the hottest planet. But no, Venus is the hottest planet because Venus like lights up in the space. So the light changes the heat of it, so it's hot. But do you know why it traps the heat in it? So, let's go on to Venus. Venus is a very hot and rocky planet with craters, mountains, and valleys. Yeah, it's very hot. Venus is a little bit smaller than Earth. It's just a little bit. It's like similar to Mars or something. Venus has an atmosphere and is covered by thick clouds that trap a lot of heat. So that's why Venus is very hot. And you know why? Why it's not hot enough? I will show you later. Venus has no moons. Yeah, it's like Mercury. No big deal. Venus takes 243 Earth days to rotate once. It takes 225 Earth days to revolve around the sun. So, it's like a lot, but not a lot as much as Earth. So it's just like that, but not much as Earth. Earth is more. Now, let's move on to planet Earth. Our planets that we are living here, right now. You are watching your living Earth. Everyone is watching that you are living in Earth. So, Earth has water and a moderate temperature. So, some planets, like the Mercury, is hot. Hot, so hot. Or like the last one, or like Jupiter, or like the outer ones are really cold. Uranus or Neptune is really cold as well. But Earth has a moderate temperature. It has cold and hot. It's like between of it. So it's a perfect temperature, yeah, for us to live. Earth has an atmosphere and swirling clouds. As you can see, there are clouds a bit swirling out here, like a swirl. You call it swirl, so it's swirling clouds. It's like a circle, but it keeps going, going, and going. Earth has one moon, only one moon. Earth takes 24 hours to rotate once. So that's why we have morning, day, and night. 24 hours. And it takes it takes 365 days. It's more than Venus. And a quarter of days. 1/4. So a quarter of days to revolve around the sun. So that's why Earth has 365 days.
Per year.
Yeah, per year. For a year. So also, Earth is the only planet in our solar system that we know it has life. So we are living here. We are humans, there are animals, there are grass, there are plants. All are in Earth because it has a perfect temperature for us to survive in there. But you know, we will soon be in Mars. Yeah, in the future. There are good technology. And the last one of the inner planets, Mars. So Mars is also perfect temperature, but not much people live there. Maybe no one lives there. Mars is called the red planet because of this reddish-orange surface. So come take a closer look. You can see here. The camera is close to here. So, the red part is a reddish and a bit slight orange of it. So it's called the red planet. But why is it not hot? Well, first, Mars is about half the size of Earth. So Earth is the biggest of all in the inner planets. Well, why is it not hot enough? Because Mars has a very thin atmosphere, so it's very thin clouds. It has volcanoes and deep canyons. Although it has volcanoes, but the Venus, the sun, close to the sun, really hot. It has fire or everything. It's trapped like this and stay hot, hot forever. Well, Mars has volcano, it's really hot. Canyons, it's really hot. But it has a thin atmosphere, so it might fade away. Yeah, so that's why. Mars has two moons. Wow, have you ever experienced with two moons, guys?
Not yet.
I don't know, not for me. But I know that one of the moon is small and one of the moon is really big. Like, something like that.
research more for the moon.
Yeah, we need to research more. Well, Mars takes 25 hours to rotate once. So it takes one more hour to rotate. Because Earth rotates 24 hours and Mars rotates 25 hours. It just plus one more hour. Not a big deal, right? It takes 687 days, Earth days, to revolve around the sun. So it's really, really long. But it's not as long as the last planet, Neptune. We will find it out in the next lesson. So these are all the ideas of Mars. Yeah. So, we learn about the inner planets, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. They're all really special. They all have their special ability. So I hope you enjoy this lesson and see you next time.